Good morning, everyone, and apologies for running a little bit late. We were just putting together the final touches on what we think is going to be a very, very major announcement for our aviation sector. We have been working for many months now on revisions to the regulations and the rights and privileges that pertain to passenger travel in the aviation sector. Those discussions have been ongoing with multiple sets of stakeholders, and we are now in a position where we can release a draft passenger charter for public consultation. So we will go through that in detail. But we also wanted to include several other elements that we are putting together to actually provide a full range of facilities and conveniences for passengers traveling in India as far as the aviation sector is concerned. And all of these different elements, the draft passenger charter and the other two or three elements that I will describe just now, form for us what we are terming as Air Seva, which is a delightful, convenient and safe passenger experience. So as far as the Air Seva initiative is concerned, as I said, there are three or four major elements. The first major element is a draft passenger charter, which brings together the rights that our passengers have, and we will go through that in detail. Second, it includes Digi Yatra, which is the digital traveler framework that we are putting in place that will enable all digital travel so that people can register and then be able to use their registered digital ID to be able to go through airports very conveniently and seamlessly. Third, it includes a revamped Air Seva app. As you remember, we had launched the Air Seva app in November of 2016, which of course has been very successful in being able to resolve and deal with a number of complaints that passengers have had. And we've been very fortunate that all the members of the aviation ecosystem have cooperated and worked together to be able to resolve passenger complaints. So that is the third element. And then the fourth element, which we've just recently announced, is Wi-Fi connectivity in the skies as well. So these are the four major elements that constitute this overall Air Seva initiative that we have. And again, as I said, the idea of the Air Seva initiative, particularly as air traffic is continuing to grow very, very rapidly and will continue to grow towards a billion trips, is to be able to provide a very safe, seamless, convenient and delightful experience for our travelers. So these are the major elements of Air Seva. And what we will now do is actually go through a detailed presentation on the passenger charter, because that I think is something that we have been working on and which I think will be something of great interest to passengers as well as all the stakeholders in the aviation ecosystem.
So would you like to go ahead with the presentation quickly?
Yeah. The hashtag includes in it four different elements. The passenger charter, and of course we are releasing it today for public consultation. Digi Yatra, the technical standards of which are almost completed, and we've been working with all the necessary stakeholders on that. Air Seva, the app through which you can register for Digi Yatra and with which you can get a lot of different information on your travel experience. And then everything we've done to improve connectivity in the skies. Next page, please. So here are some of the details on the passenger charter. So the passenger charter itself is strengthening and formalizing three or four important areas. The first area, of course, is in flight cancellations. So yes, when flights are canceled, then, of course, this is assuming the flight is canceled because it is the airline's fault. If it is something that is not the airline's fault, like weather or an air traffic control situation, and it applies to all of the airlines, then of course the airline is not held accountable. But if it is solely due to the airline's fault, then the passenger has to be compensated for a cancellation, or the ticket has to be refunded. So we are going to be issuing a draft card for that. If the flight is delayed, Then again, passengers are going to be compensated in various ways. If the flight is delayed for more than 4 hours, the airlines have to offer an option for a full refund of the ticket. If it involves a flight on the next day, then you have to provide a hotel stay with no additional charge. And if there are connecting flights that are missed, then you get compensation for those as well.
But connecting flights only if it is on the same ticket?
Yes, connecting flights only if it is on the same ticket, the same PNR. If it is a different PNR, then you don't have to pay for that. Then, of course, there are some general provisions, which is the cost of transferring passengers has to be included. And of course, if you feel like you have not been given what you should have been given by the airline, you can file your complaint on the AirSaver app. Then we have, next page please. We are strengthening the facilities that we are going to be providing to persons with special needs. We will ensure that from today, where two window seats in the front row are reserved for people with special needs, we have extended that and improved that, and then the seats have to remain blocked till close at the time of departure. So that's what we're doing for people with special needs. Now we come to a very important provision, which is around cancellation charges. So cancellation charges have been a significant point of friction, a significant pain point for passengers. And so we are proposing a lock-in option for 24 hours. And our belief is by offering this lock-in option, we will be able to take much of the friction associated with cancellation charges out of the system. Here, what we are proposing is that the ticket can be cancelled without any charges. The ticket can be cancelled without any charges for 24 hours, provided you do that 96 hours before flight departure. So 96 hours before flight departure, if you cancel your ticket within a 24-hour time period, you do not have to pay any cancellation charges. And there will be no additional charge for correction in the name of a person within 24 hours of booking the ticket. Cancellation charges have to be printed prominently, and they have to be communicated thoroughly to customers, so that customers should know that if they are booking a ticket which has cancellation charges, and those cancellation charges will be levied after 24 hours, exactly how much they can pay. And of course, we are reiterating that cancellation charges should not be higher than the basic fare plus the fuel surcharge. So as far as cancellation charges are concerned, by providing this 24-hour lock-in provision, which enables you to cancel your reservation without any charges during those 24 hours, people can change their mind, they can change their name, they can change their routing, they can change their destination. All of those things can be changed at no cost. So this, we think, is going to be a very major convenience that we will be offering to passengers. And that's what we've tried to do with cancellation charges. Next page, please. Now, as far as Digi Yatra is concerned, we are going to be rolling out the world's largest digital traveler program through Digi Yatra. We've been working on this for over a year now. The technical standards have been largely developed. We are just finalizing those. But it really is based on the Honorable Prime Minister's vision of Digital India. And we are using the underlying Aadhaar infrastructure to first authenticate a passenger, but then thereafter we will be developing database and effectively the identification procedures so that we can enable people to get through the airport without having to have any paper at all. So it will be a completely digital experience, and of course it's going to be something that will improve convenience a great deal, but in addition to that, it will also increase the throughput of our airports. Which is also very important. The Digi Yatra, of course, next page, offers multiple benefits. For passengers, no repeat identity check, less queuing, faster boarding. For airport operators, you know exactly who is inside the airport, how they're moving through the airport, how they can enhance their resources or reallocate resources to streamline passenger flows. For airlines also, better awareness about who's where and what they're doing. And of course, from a security point of view, once we know exactly who's coming into the airport, how they're moving through the airport, we have much better security management in airports as well.
And just to supplement what Honorable Minister has said, two more things. Firstly,
The Aadhaar is not mandatory. It will not be mandatory, and there will be alternate channels for getting into the airport, and alternate channels will be available. That is one. And the second thing is that actually Digi Yatra is going to result in reduction of the costs at the airport. For example, if you are in a position to just use Digi portfolio for getting inside, then the number of security personnel will go down. Now that's for which the airport operator has to pay. So that will be a big cost reduction for the airport operator. Similarly for the airlines, if you have a Digi Yatra profile with you, you can actually do self check-in, you can do self baggage drop, you will not have to go to the airline counter, in which case the cost for the airline goes down. So these costs will go down, as a result of which the overall ticket prices will also go down.
No, thank you very much, Mr. Chaubey. You're exactly right. It is definitely going to help us reduce costs. And additionally, as you correctly pointed out, this is completely a voluntary procedure, which will use Aadhaar or some other identification mechanism just once. And thereafter, you'll be registered and then you'll be able to use the underlying identification that you have with Air Seva and Digi Yatra to get through the airport. It is absolutely voluntary. We will be providing the normal paper-based processes as well. So anybody who does not want to use this can of course use what we are using right now, the traditional procedures. Mm-hmm. Those that sign up for it can get advantage of going through the digital experience and getting the convenience of that. So we are very careful about making it completely voluntary, and the architecture is designed in such a way, and we are spending a lot of time with all the stakeholders to ensure that privacy is fully protected, because of course as the Honorable Supreme Court has laid down, privacy is a fundamental right, and we have to protect that at all costs. So both the voluntary nature and the safeguards for privacy have been built into the digital Yatra system right from the outset. Let's move to the next page on Air Seva. So we are going to be completely revamping the Air Seva portal. The 1.5 release is going to be coming in July, and this 1.5 release is going to have many additional features. It will be the way through which you can register for Digi Yatra and become a registered digital traveler. You can of course do grievance reporting. You will get the most up-to-date information about flight operations, which gate your flight is at, whether there are any delays, whether the flight is on time. A whole host of facilities that are available at airports will be made accessible through Air Seva. And so we are completely revamping and redoing the Air Seva app to make travel very, very convenient for our passengers. To the best of our knowledge, there is no other app like Air Seva in the world, which brings together all stakeholders, the entire ecosystem, to enable a very, very high quality travel experience for air passengers. So this remains, to the best of our knowledge, a very unique thing that is part of India's aviation system. I won't go into Air Seva 2.0, but we have a very good roadmap in place for Air Seva 2.0 as well. That also is going to have a whole host of very valuable and very, very passenger-friendly features that will continue to make this app something that is a must-have for all air travelers. Finally, the last page on connectivity. As you know, Wi-Fi services have been allowed now above 3,000 meters and once the plane takes off. So Wi-Fi services have been allowed, and now the process is underway to get licenses and regulatory approvals for this. So we are hopeful that airlines will now take advantage of the work that we have done to enable Wi-Fi connectivity, and this will further enhance and improve passenger experience in our skies. So all in all, as I said right at the outset, we are working to improve the passenger experience, make it not just world class, but make it world leading. And to that end, our umbrella brand, our umbrella effort here is hashtag Air Seva. And as part of that, there are four important elements. Obviously, as I said, the draft passenger charter, the Digi Yatra digital traveler program, air seva, the app, and finally connectivity in the skies. So all in all, this set of efforts underway, we think will result in world-leading customer service, world-leading experiences in India's skies.
Further supplement, the passenger charter which we have presented before you is a draft passenger charter which is being put out for consultation, and within about a month after we have got everybody's input on this, we will be formally notifying it. And secondly, with regard to the in-flight Wi-Fi connectivity, Department of Telecommunications has confirmed to me that they will be in a position to award the license within about 2 months from the date that the airline or the in-flight Wi-Fi service provider actually applies for it. So depending on when they are wanting to apply, within about 2 months from that date, they should be in a position to get the license and to start rolling out the service. Now, if there are any questions or any clarifications.
One question on Wi-Fi. Do they have regulations in place? Does the telecom ministry have regulations in place to implement the rule?
Yes, they have. Actually, what they have started drafting the licensing conditions, and that process will be completed very, very quickly within the Department of Telecommunications. And that is why they have told me that they are in a position to award the license within about 2 months from the date of application. After 2 months.
Sir, can you explain what Aadhaar card not mandatory for the particular thing?
You would have noticed that the DigiYatra platform requires that when you enter the airport building, then in order to ensure that you are the right person who is the holder of that ticket, on one hand, the database at the airport has to speak to the database of the airline to confirm that the ticket is a valid ticket. On the other hand, that database has to speak to the database of Aadhaar only once to ensure that the names match and the photographs and the other biometric features match. Once that happens, then the person is authenticated. His photograph is captured at the airport. We no longer use Aadhaar database. And thereafter, using very specialized algorithms, it will be his face-based travel inside the airport thereafter. So it is only once this authentication is required, and thereafter it will not be needed. However, if there is a person who does not wish to use his Aadhaar for the travel purpose, then there will be separate gates within the airport for entry for those who wish to enter by manually showing the ticket and manually showing the ID proof. That arrangement will parallelly continue.
Use DigiYatra until
Aadhaar. For DigiYatra, if you wish to use DigiYatra platform, which is optional, you will have to have Aadhaar.
Jain sir, kab se DigiYatra ko aap shuru karne wale hain? Kahi kisi airport se iski shuruaat hogi? Iske bare mein kuch bataye?
Nahi, kai sare airports ne ispe pilots kar diye hain. Ab hum logon ki koshish ye hai ki hum log technical standards taiyar karein, jiske dwara sab airports एक ही सेट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड्स का उपयोग करें. अगर सब एयरपोर्ट्स एक स्टैंडर्ड्स का उपयोग कर रहे होंगे, और उसी के लिए हम लोग प्रतिबद्ध हैं इस समय, और पूरा हम लोगों ने एक टेक्निकल डॉक्यूमेंट तैयार भी किया है, उसके कई राउंड्स हम लोगों ने उसके कंसल्टेशंस भी किए हैं, जब ये हो जाएगा तब एक बार आप एनरोलमेंट कर लेंगे तो फिर आप हर एयरपोर्ट में उसका उपयोग कर पाइएगा. अगर हम लोग वो टेक्निकल स्टैंडर्ड्स नहीं लागू करें और सब एयरपोर्ट्स उन्हें पूरी तरीके से नहीं उसको उपयोग करें, तो आपको हर एयरपोर्ट में अलग अलग काम करना पड़ेगा. लेकिन इन स्टैंडर्ड्स के द्वारा एक बार आप एनरोल कर लीजिएगा तो आप हर एयरपोर्ट में उनका उपयोग कर सकते हैं.
डोमेस्टिक और इंटरनेशनल बोथ विल स्टार्ट?
नहीं, ये डोमेस्टिक ट्रैवल के लिए, ये इंटरनेशनल ट्रैवल के लिए नहीं है, क्योंकि इंटरनेशनल ट्रैवल के लिए आपको हर देश के साथ फिर स्टैंडर्ड्स अलाइन करने पड़ेंगे. इसमें भी बातचीत चल रही है इकाओ में, लेकिन अभी वो दूर है. हम लोग अपना डोमेस्टिक कर लें, और जैसे मैंने कहा कि जो हम लोग अपने देश में अमल करने वाले हैं वो दुनिया का सबसे विशाल डिजिटल ट्रैवलर प्रोग्राम होगा, और दुनिया में कई सारे देश हैं जो आज के समय बहुत ही ध्यान से देख रहे हैं कि भारत में क्या हो रहा है, क्योंकि अगर भारत में इस प्रकार से हम लोग इसको लागू करते हैं तो फिर वो भी उसका इस प्रकार से उपयोग कर सकते हैं. तो हम लोग इसमें ट्रेंड सेटर्स बन गए हैं.
You're going directly to the airline, so with cancellation, when you say it's 48 hours of blockage, and then you say it's 96 hours before the departure, you can get it cancelled. So how would it be really implemented?
So those are, of course, matters that have been discussed in detail with the airlines, the online travel agents, airports, and so on. First of all, to correct you, it is a 24-hour lock-in, not a 48-hour lock-in, and that is available up to 96 hours before departure. And it will be the responsibility of the airlines, which is whom we regulate. DGCA regulates the airlines. And so we will regulate the airlines to enable this feature to be made available on their systems. And then from there on, it will be available to the travel agents as well.
So the delay and cancellation charges, how does it compare in the graph? How does it compare to that which already exists now? Can you tell us in what way it has been made more stringent, if it has?
No, it has definitely been strengthened compared to the past. We can give you the exact details as to what has been modified to what extent. Akhilesh or Dhananjay, do you want to just talk about that? Exactly what are the details in terms of what was there in the past and what we have done now?
We are putting that as part of the detailed press release
okay.
in the presentation.
All right, so we will be getting you the exact details so you can do the before and after comparison and see exactly what they were in the past and what we are going to be doing
this
now. But they have been significantly strengthened.
This draft has been put up on the website already?
Sir, I have already sent it to you.
Yeah, the draft cars have been sent out.
So
yeah.
Major concern raised by the airlines in this passenger charter forum is regarding the cancellation charges. Has that been sorted out?
Yes, we have had multiple rounds of discussions with the airlines about how we intend to provide the 24-hour lock-in. Many airlines on their portals already allow this provision. They already allow your reservation to be changed within 24 hours. So it's not as if it's not already in operation right now. So we would like to make it consistent across the industry. We'll have to see exactly. Let's see what the comments consultation up. Process throws up. We will have to see what the inputs are going to be on this. So then we'll take a determination on that.
And so last minute book tickets, as in tickets, booked 96 hours before the flight, cannot be cancelled.
Without cancellation fee.
That's right. So yes. If you're booking 4 days before departure, which is 96 hours, then of course you're not going to be able to do that.
And otherwise, I mean, barring these two conditions, otherwise the cancellation fee remains, cannot be more than the base fare.
That provision continues.
That provision continues.
Only what we have added here, that previously it was only for the airlines. Now we are also making it mandatory for the agents also. So this is one addition we are adding. At the moment, the airlines can't charge more than the basic fare for the fuels charge for the cancellation charges. But this was for the airlines. Now we are adding the agents also. So this has to be done for the agents.
Agents in travel portals also, sir?
Yes.
Agents and travel portals, yes. Anybody who's booking tickets and issuing PNRs.
Sir, so you mentioned that if it is established that cancellation is because of the airline's fault, who will establish this and how will a passenger at the airport be able to see previous selected?
We will ask DGCA to determine that. I'll ask Mr. Bhullar to answer that.
I think it's matters of detail. If it is beyond the airlines, of course we know what is the ATC issues, meteorological issues, other. So we'll be able to determine that.
It's actually
the DGCA is very difficult to tell here, but that is something we'll be able to do.
So DGCA is quite capable of figuring out whether it is the airline's fault or not. If it is the airline's fault, then they are accountable for compensating the passengers. No, our expectation would be, and of course we've discussed this with the airlines, if the airline is at fault, it has to acknowledge that it is at fault. And of course, as I said, if there's an air traffic control delay or there are weather-related delays and they are across the board, that is, they affect every airline, then under those circumstances that the airline is not at fault. If it is a mechanical failure, if there is a snag, if the crew doesn't come, then it's clearly the airline's fault and then the airline is accountable. And then our expectation is, and our airlines are very responsible and very clear about what their obligations are, they will step forward and say, it is our responsibility and we will compensate passengers accordingly. So we expect our airlines to do that, and if that is not happening, then of course you can talk to various people at the airport, or go through Air Seva, or talk to the DGCA.
Sir, you said that 5,000 से 20,000
तक कम कंपनसेशन है, अगर डिले होता है या कैंसिल होता है, या रीजन होते हैं कि अगर फ्लाइट एयरलाइंस यानी उनके ही कारण डिले और कैंसिलेशन हुआ है, तब उन्हें फिर मुआवजा देना पड़ेगा। अगर एयर ट्रैफिक कंट्रोल के कारण, मौसम के कारण, यानी कि सब एयरलाइंस इससे प्रभावित हैं, तब एक एयरलाइन इसे दोषी नहीं कहला दिया जा सकता है। ये कि वो एयरलाइन दोषी है कि नहीं दोषी है, ये DGCA इसको समझ सकता है, इस पर पूरी तरीके से अध्ययन करके आपको बता सकता है।
Would like to speak into the mic, just mic.
Because of the storm, one particular airline was not able to take off at somewhere around 10 in the night, and passengers were seen sitting on the tarmac waiting inside the aircraft for virtually the entire night. Here, obviously, the trigger was the storm, but then obviously other factors took over. So in this case, who's liable?
Not the airline.
It was a weather-related issue. And after that, what happened was that the FDTL and all those kicked in.
Yeah.
So it was not that the airline was at fault, at least prima facie, that's what it appears in this particular case. But these are precisely the kind of incidents and situations that DGCA has to investigate and come to a conclusion on, and they are very well equipped to do that. Let's not try and resolve that right now. We understand exactly how to ascertain responsibility in these issues. DGCA is very well equipped to do that. And when, as and when these cases arise, we will be able to come up with the right answer. We can't sit here and come up with the case law around it. So let's leave it to DGCA to figure out who's at fault. And if indeed the airline is at fault, then the airline has to compensate passengers. Yes, we have strengthened those also, and they are in the details that are being provided to you. But essentially, what we are trying to do as far as death, injury and baggage loss is concerned, is to bring India up to global standards.